Hey guys, I'm Venkat and this is part 7 of Web Development with Blazor video series. I'll include the link to the course playlist in the description box below this video. So here is what we want to be able to do. Display a loading animation in a Blazor web application. In a real world, there are many use cases where we need a loading spinner or indicator. For example, your app is processing a report and it takes a few seconds to complete, or a server-side REST API is being called and it's taking a few seconds to retrieve data, maybe because of a slow network connection, server busy, or just because you're retrieving lots and lots of data. Whatever may be the case, if your app is taking a bit of time to do something, it's better to display a loading indicator so the end user knows the application is busy processing the request and not frozen. You can see the loading spinner in action. On the home page, our app is retrieving data from a server-side REST API. Because we have a few seconds delay in retrieving data, we see the loading spinner. As soon as the data becomes available, the loading animation disappears and we see the data. We're going to use Sync Fusion spinner component to get the loading animation effect. It's very simple and easy to use. Let's take a look at the steps. Notice, at the moment when we navigate to the homepage, we see employee data immediately without any delay. That's because in our employees database table, we only have 4 rows, and for the REST API to return these 4 rows, it doesn't really take that long. So let's introduce some artificial latency. And we already know it is this index razor component that displays the list of employees. And we have the call to our REST API right here. So before the REST API returns employee data, let's introduce some artificial latency. And for that, I'm going to use task.delay, and we specify the delay in milliseconds, 3000 milliseconds, that is 3 seconds. Notice, first the table header appears, and after 3 seconds, employee data appears. So here's what we want to do. While we are waiting for employee data, we want to display the loading spinner. Our first step is to install this spinner NuGet package, syncfusion.blazor.spinner. Now, take a look at this index razor page. On this page, we are using syncfusion grid component. So if we take a look at packages under dependencies, notice the syncfusion blazor grid NuGet package is already installed, and this package has a dependency on the spinner package, syncfusion.blazor.spinner. Since this package is already installed, we don't have to install it separately again. Next, let's open index.html file, and this file is present in this folder, www.root. Reference syncfusion bootstrap 4 theme file. The styles in this file are required for both syncfusion grid and spinner components. Next, let's open this imports.razor file. Just like how we have a using declaration for syncfusion grid component, we need a using declaration for syncfusion spinner component. Next, in program.cs file, we have main method, and in this method, we need to add syncfusion blazor services. In our case, the required services are already added when we added the syncfusion grid component. So all that is left right now to do is use the spinner component in any of our application pages. In our case, we want to add it on this index razor page. And notice this syncfusion grid component is binding to employees property. And we're using the REST API to retrieve employees data. And this is what is taking at least 3 seconds because we have introduced some artificial latency here. So let's check if this employees property is null. If the employees property is null, that means we have not yet retrieved the data, so we want to display the spinner. So let's do a null check. If employees property is null, we want to display the spinner component. We still see a red squiggly. That's because we have not saved imports.razor. The moment we save it, that red squiggly should be gone. SF, by the way, stands for syncfusion. Syncfusion spinner, we have turned on the visibility. So if employees is null, then display the spinner, else display the syncfusion grid component with the list of employees. Notice, while we are waiting for data, we see the spinner component. As soon as the data becomes available, the spinner component disappears and we see the grid with a list of 4 employees. Now, let me set label property, and we can set it to any string we want. I'm going to set it to loading data. With this in place, notice, along with the spinner, we see the text as well. We can also specify the size for the spinner. For that, we use the size property. Let me actually set it to 50 pixels. By default, the spinner size is 30 pixels, but obviously we can increase or decrease it depending on our application requirements. We can also specify spinner type. By default, the type is none, where the Blazor spinner is loaded based on the theme used in the application. You can see the available types on the screen. In this application, we are using Bootstrap 4 theme, so let me explicitly set spinner type to Bootstrap 4. We can also change the spinner color. For that, include this style. Keep in mind, we are using Bootstrap 4 theme and I'm changing the color to red. Notice, now the spinner is slightly bigger and its color is also red. If you're wondering, how do I know I have to include this style to change the spinner color? Well, the answer is SyncFusion documentation. For example, to get to spinner component documentation, navigate to their website, syncfusion.com, then click on Products, Blazor. On this page, search for spinner. Click on it. On this page, search for documentation. Click this button. If you're getting started with the Blazor spinner component, then use the documentation on this Getting Started page. If you want to customize the spinner, use this page. If you want to change the style and appearance, use this page. Remember, in our application, we're using Bootstrap 4 theme. So if we scroll down a bit, we have the style here for Bootstrap 4 theme to change the spinner color. At the moment, we have hard-coded spinner visibility to true. We can also bind it to a Boolean property in our component class. Let's see how to do that. First, let's create a property in our component code. The property is of type Boolean. Let's call the property spinner visible. As soon as this async operation starts to retrieve our REST API data, we want to set this spinner visible property to true. After it completes, let's set it to false. We can now use this spinner visible property to control the visibility of the spinner. Instead of using this visible property, we are going to use bind visible property and bind it to our spinner visible property. With this in place, we no longer need this if check. We actually need it on the grid, so let me cut it, and we don't need these brackets as well, so let's get rid of them. If employee is not equal to null, then display the grid. Now, the visibility of the spinner is controlled by this property. Notice, even now, the spinner works exactly the same as before. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.